following is a presentation of the National Sim Racing League of America. Hello everybody, this is Napa Fan here, and this is race number 18 in season number 4 of the NRLOA Turkey Hill Series. We are here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park for the first time ever in the Turkey Hill Series for the Kroger 200. One of the shortest races of the season as well, only 40 laps around the 0.686 mile speedway. Just over to the west, I do believe, of the big Indianapolis Motor Speedway where we'll be racing next weekend. But right now, some short track action from Indianapolis Raceway Park. And it's definitely going to play into the championship very well, especially considering the guy who's only 1 point off the points lead is going to start third. Ryan Madden, 1 point off of Alex Bonsignor, who is the points leader. 425 points towards the championship for him. Like I said, Madden only 1 point behind. Isaac Redmond is only 9 points behind the points lead. Nick Smith is 10 points behind. And Nathan Faden, 26 behind. Coming into today's event, after this one, there will only be 10 races left in the season to crown a champion. And these points have been tight pretty much the entire season, so it's still a fair game for everybody. And it's going to be fascinating to see who gets it done once we head to Homestead. The end of September, it's going to be less than 3 months from now, and we will crown a champion here in the Turkey Hill Series. We're here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park. There will be no pit stops in this race because the race is so short. They're not going to have a need to come down the pit lane, so that's a good thing there. Fisher G on the pole alongside him. Alex Russell in the double zero. You have Ryan Madden starting alongside Sebastian Coquelin. Last time we had a standalone event here in the Turkey Hill Series, Coquelin won at New Hampshire. Casey Hoffman alongside Angel Olvera, Mark Davidson and Nathan Faden, Dale Solzman and Nathan Baird. The top five rows, top 10 starting positions here from IRP, making sure everybody's rolling off. There's your points leader, Alex Bonsignor, midway through the field in the 01. I believe everybody's going to roll off and we'll have ourselves a pretty decent race here tonight. Like I said, only 40 laps long. This is most likely going to be the shortest race of the season, but it's got potential to be a pretty good one. We'll have to see how it all goes down. Fisher G and the double zero of Alex Russell on the front row. But Ryan Madden's the guy to watch out for. He could easily take the points lead at the end of this race. Coming off the final corner, we're taking the green flag. We're racing in the Kroger 200 here at IRP. Lap 1 will be led by Fisher G at the line. He was able to clear the double zero off of turn number 4. And Ryan Madden looking to get around the double zero as well as he started on the inside lane too. Now Madden has not won a race yet this season. And interestingly enough, neither has Alex Bonsignor. But they're the top two in points coming into this race. And they're both very experienced drivers. A lot of Chick-fil-A Cup Series experience between those two guys, and it's no surprise to see him running up front on the points this season here in the Turkey Hill Series. But right now, all eyes are on Fisher G in the 40 as he pulls out to a pretty significant lead. And remember, there are no pit stops in this race. Thank God. And Fisher G's got a pretty good chance of winning because of that, because he can just race this whole thing out. If he races it clean and no cautions come out, which we have not had an incident yet, it's possible we might get one. But considering that they kind of got through those first few laps pretty cleanly, we might be able to race this thing completely green the whole way through. Casey Hoffman trying to get to the inside of Ryan Madden. Madden's way up the racetrack. And the 33 is going to look to the inside of the 24 for second place. That's exactly what Fisher G wants to see. Remember the Napa Truck Series last season? Fisher G won the last two races of the season. Went back to back right at the end. I heard a bit of scraping, and that's Alex Russell. He didn't get off that outside lane, and he hit the wall hard, and he's falling back like a rock in the double zero. It's a tough break for the California winner who won in his first start, and we do have a yellow on the racetrack as Cameron Gaggio has gone around in the number 7. It's been a tough one for Cameron Gaggio in his return to racing here on Napa Fan on a full-time basis, and doesn't look like it's going to work out too well for him here tonight at IRP. And that 1 second lead that Fisher G had is erased, as the 33 of Casey Hoffman is going to be right behind him on the restart. Mark Davidson got around Ryan Madden there for the third position. Madden is in fourth right now with Angel Olvera, our Atlanta winner, running in the fifth position. Everyone should be able to continue after that one. Looks like it was just a simple spin down the backstretch. We're going to go ahead and see what happened to bring up the first caution of the night here in the Kroger 200. As it was very simple, only going to review it once here. Colton Yeo in the 98, getting into him off of turn number 2 and not letting off either. And that was right at the end of the field anyway, so it doesn't really affect Cameron Gaggio that much. He basically just loses one position. So does give these guys a break, and it does affect Fisher G right there, because that huge lead he had on Casey Hoffman is gone. And Hoffman's going to have a chance at striking here on the restart. Let's see what happens on that restart here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park. We are back here, the Lucas Oil Raceway, the other name for this place. Even though we do officially call it the Indianapolis Raceway Park, it's actually officially now the Lucas Oil Raceway, but, you know, it can't get too technical. The version we use is the Indianapolis Raceway Park, so that's what we call it. Fisher G is the leader, followed by Casey Hoffman, Mark Davidson, Ryan Madden, Angel Olvera. Everybody's still on the lead lap here around this tight racetrack, and a quarter of the way through this one. Here in the Kroger 200. Restart zone is right at the start-finish line, so once Fisher G hits that start-finish line, we'll be back to racing. It was not a good restart for Fisher G at all, and there goes Casey Hoffman, right to the inside to take it away on lap 11. They're side-by-side for the lead down the backstretch. And Casey Hoffman, I think he's going to do it, or is he? Fisher G trying to get that run up top, but he's going to scrape the outside wall, and there goes Hoffman the clear. Casey Hoffman going for his first career Napa Fan win. Oh boy, three wide behind them as Olvera moves to the inside of Davidson and Fisher G. Fisher G stuck on the outside as he's falling back. But Olvera looking to the inside of Davidson. Look at Ryan Madden. He moved his way back up to the second position. He got around both Fisher G and Mark Davidson. Great run for the 24. But Casey Hoffman, the story of the field right now, like I said, going for his first career Napa Fan win. Caleb Hoffman, a 17-time winner, I do believe. Actually, might be 18. Yeah, I think he's an 18-time winner on Napa Fan. And if Casey were to win, that would put Caleb's amount of drivers at 19. But it wouldn't tie Caleb Hoffman for Garrett Sonora, so it doesn't really matter too much for Caleb, as the caution's back out again, and a big wreck down the backstretch. Matt Hamill around. Ryan Kendall, the Dover winner, with heavy damage there, and they're all trying to figure it out now through turn number 2. Does appear that that's going to be it, but tough break for those guys. Hopefully Casey can stop here in time. Oh boy, a bit of a tap there, but I think everyone's going to be okay, as they are trying to figure out who's in what position here, as they did cross the line. It's going to take them a little while to figure it out, but I think they got it. But either way, Casey Hoffman out front now. He will lead on the restart. This is an opportunity for Ryan Madden to possibly strike on the restart. We'll have to see if he can do so. Only 1 point off of Alex Bongsignor. Bongsignor is currently trying to find him in the field. He's just outside the top 10, so he's going pretty well for the 0-1, but very good chance he won't be the points leader at the end of the day. Anyways, let's see what happens to bring out the second caution here in the Kroger 200 at the Indianapolis Raceway Park. So this wreck a lot more complex than the first one we had. Nathan Fain got into the outside wall. Jordan Lopez and Alex Mann were trying to get to the inside of him, and Faden came back down. This is not what Faden needs. He came into this one only 26 off, and he's going to fall back after that one. Alex Mann in the inside wall there, and this is a narrow racetrack. There's not much room to maneuver around all that. You see Josh Crash and Emmett Juckum, Tyson Conway, the Iowa winner, also involved in this, and they all jam it up back in here as well. Our last winner there, Justin Zeidel. Then you got Matt Tuck pushing into Matt Hamill there, and Ryan Kendall got spun to the inside, trying to avoid that as well. But Jordan Lopez also around. He's had a tough season. Did get a second place finish at Armory Digital, but still has not gotten a win this season. It's a tough one for him, but see all these guys involved. Tough break for everyone involved here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park. Replay this in real time, following with Nathan Faden in the 19. He went around there, Alex Mann, Jordan Lopez, and then they jam it up behind. As you see everyone go around there, Ryan Kendall with damage in the 97, our Dover winner, Matt Hamill in the 62. A lot of good drivers involved in that one, but it's going to give us another restart in this race. Casey Ottman's the leader in the 33, let's see what he can do on the restart. Here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park. I don't know if that damage is going to affect Ryan Madden, but we're going to have to see when we come back. Back to racing here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park, and we will restart with 21 laps to go in the Kroger 200. Already two yellows in this race, but I don't think we're going to break our record of the season with six at New Hampshire. That race was a little topsy-turvy, to say it the least. This one, we don't have any pit stops, so that does keep things in check rather well. And definitely a breath of fresh air for these guys, because, just for the Chick-fil-A Cup Series, they're going to need it. They're going to need a race without any cautions here soon. They need a race without any cautions, let me tell you that. They need a race without pit stops, and it's just been getting a little crazy over there as of late. But here, no pit stops in this one, so we don't have to worry. It's a flat-out race with Hoffman, Madden, Kukulon, Olvera, and Davidson, the top five. There goes Davidson to the inside of Olvera. That's for the fourth position. And Davidson's been doing a really good job as of late. He has been awarded the hot seat the past four races there for North State Racing, and he's going for his fifth. I don't think anybody ahead of him is part of the North State stable here in the Turkey Hill Series, so it looks like Davidson's going to also attempt Indianapolis next weekend for the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. I'm hoping that's the case, because this guy has really been showing some stuff here in that number 99. Casey Hoffman in the number 33 hangs on. Madden did not get a jump there. Fisher G.R. Pulsiter is trying to move his way back up. He is currently running in the 7th position, as he's battling with Nathan Baird for 6th. Here's Adam Lewis to the inside of the double zero. Our points leader Alex Bonchignor just outside the top 10 and 12th. Great run for him. That's what you need as the points leader. But the problem for him is that the guy who's only 1 point behind him is battling for the lead right now. Ryan Madden closing in on Casey Hoffman. We'll have to see if he can do it. And he also got Sebastian Kukulon. Now, this track is very similar to New Hampshire. It's got a lot of character of New Hampshire, and that's where Kukulon won his last race here this season. He's going for his third win of the season. And let me tell you, he's doing a pretty good job right now, running in the third position. And yeah, this track is very similar to New Hampshire. Both New Hampshire and this racetrack are new tracks to the schedule, but I think a lot of these guys are more prepared for this race considering they went to New Hampshire. Olvera to the inside of the 99 of Mark Davidson. That is for fourth. Great run there for Olvera, taking it away. Olvera, the co-owner of Zeidel Motorsports. That's why he's not part of the hot seat, by the way. We don't really mention it too much over in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series that he is a co-owner of that team. Maybe it's because Zeidel Motorsports yet to get a win this season now. They're doing very solid over in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. Got two of their drivers currently in the top 10, only two races left, and it looks like we have another yellow Trey right around in turn number 3, as he got into it with Tyson Conway, and the yellow's back out the third time tonight. It's been an interesting race. I wouldn't quite call it a crash fest because, you know, we're getting some laps in here under green. But our third yellow of the night is Trey Wright has gone around with Tyson Conway. Everybody except for the 16 at Joseph Simwell, who has appeared to have gone a lap down. There might have been an issue on that ride, and He's currently a lap down, but another opportunity for Ryan Madden or even Sebastian Cucullon to possibly get around Casey Hoffman for the lead here. Let's go ahead and see what happened to Trey Wright and Tyson Conway to bring out the third caution of the night here in the Kroger 200. So coming off of turn number four, they squeeze play just a little bit there. I'm wondering if Matt Hamill gets into Ryan Kendall. Yep, that's what happens right there. That shoots Kendall up into the 39. 39 just minding his own business right there. They all shoot up into the outside. Well, Conway gets a piece of that one. Kendall does not lift off, and the 39 gets spun. Entering turn number one. I thought that was turn number three. It's actually turn number one where this happens. They look very similar. Matt Hamill avoids this one. A little bit of tap there from Noah Clifton. Tyson Conway got a piece of it in the 78. They're going to fall to the back of the field after this one. Replay this in real time for Trey Wright, the American Motorsports owner in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. They're hoping for a good run tomorrow night at Nashville. Not a good night for Trey Wright here at IRP. Casey Hoffman still the leader. Let's see what he does on the restart here in the Kroger 200 for the Turkey Hill Series season number four. And we're back here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park for Casey Hoffman, the leader of the Kroger 200. A funny fact here about Kroger, they actually own the Turkey Hill brand of convenience stores that are in this area where I live here in Pennsylvania, and I just realized that. Now, the Turkey Hill convenience stores and the Turkey Hill ice cream are, I believe, still separate entities. They're related, but they're not actually the same thing. This series is sponsored by the Turkey Hill Ice Cream, Turkey Hill Ice Tea section. The Turkey Hill convenience stores, they're owned by Kroger, and this race is the Kroger 200. So, pretty cool little tidbit right there. So, Kroger and Turkey Hill, you know, they're good friends. So, that works out for this race. But Casey Hoffman, the leader. Ryan Madden, Sebastian Cucullon, Angel Olvera, and Mark Davidson, and Hoffman did not get a good restart right there. Madden straight to the inside with 10 laps to go, but Cucullon in the 42 right there. Hoffman on the outside, trying to get the run up there. He's got it, and Casey Hoffman stays out front here at the Indianapolis Raceway Park. What a move there by the number 33. He hung it up there on the outside and got it to stick off the 24. But Madden's right back to the back bumper, back to the inside, entering turn number one. Hoffman almost in the outside wall, but not quite. He's going to try to get the run up there. Not going to do it. Ryan Madden to the inside for the lead. He takes it away from Casey Hoffman on lap 32. Hoffman in the outside wall. He's going to try to keep it up there, but he taps it, and he falls to fourth and maybe fifth. A tough break for Casey Hoffman. Got stuck up there, and Ryan Madden is now out front in the number 24. Second in the points coming into this race with a win here today. He would shoot to the points lead heading into the Indianapolis Motor Speedway race next weekend right here on Napa Fan. And how about this for Ryan Madden? One of the most experienced guys in the field, looking for his first win of the year on Napa Fan. Lap 34 of 47 laps to go here in the Kroger 200, but this thing is not over yet. Sebastian Cucullon right there in the 42, looking to close in on the 24. And remember what I said, this place is very similar to New Hampshire, where Cucullon got his second win of the season. This is the kind of racetrack where Cucullon excels. He's excelling right now, running second behind the 24. We'll see if he can do it. Mark Davidson running third. Great run for him. Alex Russell and Fisher Gier pulls it back up inside the top five. There's Alex Bongsignor. He's stuck on the outside right now. He's up to ninth, but he's going to lose one there to 10th. And another to Micah Knapp. The yellow is back out. Madden won the race back, but we're going to have another restart. And it looks like Nicholas Wade and Josh Crouch got into each other. A couple of the winners from this season. Wade at Michigan and Crash at Texas. No, wait. Crash at South Boston, which is actually very similar to this place as well. It hasn't been Josh Crash's night. Crash almost won at Texas, but kind of got screwed out of a win right there as he had to come down near the end and it gave it to Cookie Helms. But either way, this race is not over. We will have a one-lap dash, I do believe, to finish this one out because we still have five laps to go. It's a four-lap caution period, so they're easily going to have at least one lap to go, I should say. Possibly two. We'll have to see how that all goes down. But let's see what went down between Nicholas Wade and Josh Crash to bring out the fourth caution of the race here at IRP. Replay this here. Matt Hamill sandwiching the six that Josh crashed in between him and Ryan Madden, and Nicholas Wade had nowhere to go. Pops him right there in the number zero. Tough break for those guys involved, but they were deep in the field either way. And that's the extent of what happened to bring out the fourth and hopefully what will be final caution of the race here at IRP. Let's go ahead and get to this restart. It's going to be a good one for Ryan Madden, Sebastian Coucoulon, Mark Davidson with a shot in the 99. Let's see who gets it done here in the Kroger 200. The drivers just took the white flag. Under caution, we will not get back to racing. I'm a little surprised by that one. Caution came out lap 35 with 5 laps to go. A normal caution period's only 4 laps, but they extended it. And this race will end under caution with Ryan Madden in victory lane in the number 24. A really good move there on the last restart to get around Casey Hoffman to take the lead and the win away. And this is definitely crucial towards the championship, but Madden's not going to have too much of a lead on Bongsignor because Bongsignor finished 10th in this race. That's exactly what Bongsignor needs as well. And, you know, it could come down to Madden and Bongsignor once we head to Homestead. Of course, only 10 races left after this one. And it's going to be very fascinating to see what happens in these final 10 races. But here tonight at IRP, it's Ryan Madden in victory lane in the Kroger 200. Great win there for 24 team of Ryan Madden. Go on the victory lane for the first time this season. They're not official quite yet. I'm going to wait for everyone to roll by. And there they go. Sebastian Coucoulon, Mark Davidson, Alex Russell, Fisher G, the top five. Angel Olvera, Casey Hoffman, Adam Lewis, Alex Mann, and Alex Bonsignor, the top 10. Take a look at the rest of the results. A lot of guys finishing a lap down this because they kind of just called it before they all crossed the line right there. So that is the result of that. But everyone officially finishing on the lead lap. And see Master Helms, Bright, Jamie Lee all back in there. And everyone else. Bit of a topsy-turvy race here at IRP. Not as topsy-turvy as it was at New Hampshire, but still a fascinating one. And those restarts definitely came into play. We saw Casey Hoffman get around Fisher G at the first restart, and then Ryan Madden getting around Casey Hoffman on the third restart of the race, and that's what officially got Ryan Madden the win here tonight at IRP. Heading into Indianapolis next weekend, it's going to be a good one for the whatever it's going to be 250. I think it's Penn Grade, but I can't remember if that's actually the sponsor of it or not. I can't remember, and I should be able to know that. But either way, Ryan Madden, the winner here at Indianapolis Raceway Park. Tomorrow night, Cup Series racing from Nashville. We already recorded it. It's a doozy, let me tell you that. I think it was a pretty good race. You'll see it tomorrow night. You'll have your own opinions on it, but I recommend watching that one. It's a pretty good one. Only 2 races left before the chase over there in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. You need to check that out and see what's going on over there. But anyways, thank you guys very much for watching. Congratulations to Ryan Madden. Next race in Indianapolis for the Turkey Hill Series, race 19 next weekend from the big one. And 2.5 mile speedway right there. It's always a great race for it as well, for the Turkey Hill Series as well. Indianapolis in NR is great. Let me just tell you that. It's great. Totally unlike stock car racing and Indianapolis in real life, so definitely check it out next weekend. But anyways, thank you guys very much for watching. Here are the points for the Turkey Hill Series, and I will see you guys later.